What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. Please make sure to like, subscribe, comment, share, you know, all that good stuff. Now today I'm super excited because look at my hair, it's blonde. This is how my hair used to look, you know, black. It was super short back then because this is an old video, by the way, but this is how my hair was and this is how my hair is now. Bleached, and you know, don't look too closely because you might see some bald spots, but it's okay. Okay, now I've been wanting to bleach my hair for the longest and I'm so happy I finally got to do it. This is the look I'm gonna be slaying today, so keep watching to see how I do it, loves. Now, like always, you know, I gotta get my lips looking right, you know, and feeling right. I got my physician's formula argan oil on there and I'm just rubbing it in, and then of course I gotta get my face looking right too and prepared for my makeup, and I'm using my face primer from Makeup Revolution. I always start out by brushing my brows, making sure all the hair is going in one direction. And then I take my brow pencil, a dark brown brow pencil, and start to draw my brows in. My brows are already pretty full, so all I have to do is outline and fill them in. If you are someone who don't have that much hair on your brows, then you might want to go in and fill them in a little bit more and make them bigger if you like big brows. And also, I will give a full description of everything that I use in the description. Most times I will use a really light concealer under my brows to conceal it, but nowadays I'm starting to use a color that's a little closer to my skin tone, just right under the brows. And then when I get down to the lid, like directly on the lid, I'll use that really light concealer for prepping my lid for my eyeshadow. For today's look, I'm using the exact same concealer that I just used under my brows. Usually I'll use a much darker shade on the top of my brows to clean it up, but today I want my brows to show, so I'm going in with the light concealer, which is not too far from my skin. And then in the middle area, or coming closer to the middle area, I'm using a little bit more darker concealer to conceal the middle area so it's not too light. I am now just brushing the middle area to soften it up and get it looking natural. Now I'm gonna blend out my concealer under and on top of my brows and bring it down a little bit on top of my lid. Hey, she's in love with who I am. Back in high school, I used to bust it to the dance. Now I hit the FBO with double. Now I'm applying that lighter concealer that I talked about earlier directly on top of my lids to prep it for my eyeshadow. Now that that is done, I'm going to start out with my first shade, which is a dark brown, darkish brownish color. And the palette I'm using is the Voss Essentials palette. And the color that I'm using is called Cinnamon. I'm now going to top it off with the color Sand, just on the top of that dark brown to buff it out and blend it. I'm now going to start my cut crease. First, I apply some of that concealer to my lids. I couldn't think of what the name was for a second. I'm gonna apply some concealer to my lids and lift my eyes up just to create a mark as to where I need to cut my crease. And I'm doing kind of like a half cut crease. I forgot what this is called, but I'm not going all the way to either corner of my eyes. I'm just doing just that middle area. And y'all, I struggled a lot with this cut crease, so you will see that one eye did not come out as great as the other eye. But this was my very first time doing this, so don't judge too hard, please. Thank you. So I'm just blending it out here, the concealer, and making sure everything is blended as usual. I'm now applying a mixture of Cinnamon and the color Black to the outer corner and inner corner of my eye and leaving that middle area for my gold.
Yeah. shook, yeah.
The next shade I'm applying is called Terracotta or Terracotta, and I'm just applying it to the outer corners of the gold, not the outer corners of my eye, but just the gold, and leaving that middle area really bright. I'm now just going in with a little bit of black mixed with that cinnamon, the brown color, and getting the outer corners of my eyes to pop and really bring that gold out. Now it's time for liner. I'm gonna do a quick wing liner going all the way out, almost touching the brows, but not quite. I want a really dramatic bold liner for this look. I'm gonna pop on some lashes real quick and ta-da, looking cute. Okay, and now it is face time. I primed my face already with some coconut oil, so now I'm just gonna go straight into the foundation, and oops, I almost got into my mouth. And then I'm also gonna add some color corrector and blend it with my foundation all over my face. Alakazam, yes ma'am, all blended. Now we are going to do a little dance. Yeah, okay. Do a little dance, and then we're gonna start doing some concealer under the eyes, and I'm using the that exact same shade concealer that I did for under my brows. I'm using my contour stick from R&K, by Kiss, and I'm just contouring my nose, sides of my cheeks, forehead, temple area, and jawline. I am using a damp beauty blender to blend out my contour. Time to bake, and for that I am using my setting powder from Fenty Beauty. I am applying it under my eyes, forehead, down my nose, on top of my lip, my chin, and the side of my face. And then really the excess powder that's left on the brush, I just use it and apply it all over and set the entire face. I'm using a blending sponge and applying some banana powder from Makeup Revolution, which is a lighter shade powder than the Fenty Beauty, and I'm just applying it directly under my eyes and down my nose. I'm just adding some color under my eyes. I'm using that cinnamon shade in a little bit of black under, and then on the very crease or very corner of my eye, not crease but corner of my eye, I'm gonna put a little bit of gold in there. Now it's time for some happy dancing while I let this powder bake. I'm gonna add some mascara to my bottom lashes, and then I'm gonna use that same brush that I used to apply my powder and just wipe everything off and make sure there's no excess powder or anything on my face. The bronzer that I'm using is from Argan by Kiss, and I forgot what the shade is called, but I'm just using that to bronze up my cheeks and sides of my nose. And then I am applying some highlight from Makeup Revolution. I'm using one of their highlight palettes, and I'm just making sure those cheeks are popping and my nose, a little bit on top of my brow bone or under my brow bone. And of course, never forget to set that face with some setting spray from Makeup Revolution. And now a little happy dance, and let's get into the lips. Now I'm sorry I didn't show the starting process of my lips, but all I did was I just used some purple lipstick, and now I'm going in with my eyeshadow palette and add in some black, a little bit of black and dark purple from that same palette, and I'm just gonna outline it with some gold and put a little bit of gold in the middle, and that's about it for the lips.
Shorty in the back, she says she
And this is it for this look today. I appreciate you all so very much for watching. Please make sure to hit that notification bell and subscribe to keep updated on all my looks, okay? Love you all. Bye-bye.